Hey, what's up? It's Cal Beck. We're here on the red carpet for Tony Hawk's Foundation Stand Up for SkateParks.
Well, the Tony Hawk Foundation started about 14 years ago when I saw the interest in skating rising, but the support not matching that popularity in terms of cities providing facilities for the kids to skate, and a lot of kids were largely discouraged for skating, and especially in the low-income areas where they have more challenges, they find a healthy outlet and they're discouraged from doing it. So we set out to change that tide and to empower the kids that want to help their communities and empower the communities that want to get something going and give them the resources, give them funding, and it's been great. We've helped to fund over 500 skate parks now.
Do you remember your first skate park or your first ramp that you built with your friends, and can you tell us a little bit about that?
I grew up in Boston, Massachusetts, so the very first ramp we built was just like driveway ramps, and we built a quarter pipe in the driveway, and we always wanted a half pipe, and my friend Billy Doyle got permission to put a half pipe in his backyard, so we got a bunch of kids after school, and we picked up the quarter pipe, and we walked it 8 blocks to his backyard, and we handed it over the picket fence, and then we dropped it on the fence on the way over, so we broke his fence. Eventually, we got our first half pipe, and it was 8 foot wide, 8 foot high, with PVC coping cut in half on the top of it. And I remember PVC coping? Plastic coping, it's scary. Cut in half, nailed on, and that's the ramp I learned to skate on. I learned inverts, I learned airs on that ramp. And that was in 1985 in Melrose, Massachusetts. And when it snowed, we had to shovel off the ramp before we could skate.
Well, I actually lived near one of the last parks that was open in the US, Del Mar Skate Ranch. And that was never lost on me, how lucky I was to have that facility. And I think that was probably the catalyst for all of this. I mean, honestly, because I had that place to go. I had a place to share ideas. I had a place where I felt like I was supported in what I was doing, even though what I was doing was much different than most of the kids. And I knew that I was very lucky, and I never lost that.
Have you ever skateboarded as a younger child?
Yes, sir. You know it.
Did you have a favorite spot to skate? Or
just pools, yeah, pipes. Had a crummy ramp I built. It was really bad, but wiped out a lot, but it was good.
It was a dangerous ramp, huh?
Yeah. It was horrible, but it was really fun to do.
You've skated all over the world. Can you tell me how other countries embrace skateboarding compared to the United States?
United States is the birthplace of skateboarding. Southern California, this is like where the media is. This is where most of the pros are. We can skate outside in December in shorts and a t-shirt. And I never take that for granted, being from Boston. But I actually just flew here from South Africa. And there's a great skate park in Kimberley, South Africa, of all places. This was our fifth year over there. And there's an international competition. People come from all over the world and all over Africa to skate, 50 different countries to skate this one event. It's called the Kimberley Diamond Cup in this little town in Africa. So it is a global phenomenon. And the Tony Hawk Foundation's been doing a great job of supporting it and nurturing it and helping empower kids to get skate parks built.